So now, good morning, all of you. We are starting class 10, chapter number 6, geography, manufacturing industry. I think you all are aware about manufacturing. When we are talking about manufacturing, that means production of goods in large quantities. After processing from raw materials to more valuable products is called manufacturing. As paper is manufactured from wood, sugar from sugarcane, iron and steel from iron ore, and aluminium from bauxite. And even some types of clothes are manufactured from yarn, which itself is an industrial product. So, manufacturing involves different types of activities, or we can call it secondary activities. In primary, people extract, exploit natural resources and obtain raw materials. But when we convert this raw material into useful goods, it is called manufacturing or secondary sector. The workers employed in steel factories, car, textile, etc., fall in this category. Some people are employed in providing services, that is called tertiary sectors. But in this chapter, we will be concerned with manufacturing industries, which fall in the secondary sector. So now, manufacturing industries. When we are talking about manufacturing industries, the economic strength of a country is associated or measured by the development of manufacturing industries. Manufacturing industries are machine-based or power-driven production units. In this, processing of raw materials takes place for converting this into a valuable commodity. Now, we will discuss about the importance of manufacturing. Now, importance of manufacturing. Manufacturing sector is considered the backbone of development. In general, an economic development, because manufacturing industries not only help in modernizing agriculture, which forms the backbone of our economy. It also reduces the heavy dependence of people on agricultural income by providing jobs in secondary and tertiary sector. Since people are getting employment, that means shifting from primary to secondary sector. And that means industrial development is a precondition for a reduction of unemployment and poverty from our country. This was the main philosophy after independence, when our government adopted public sector industries and joint sector. The main aim, the main purpose behind this, bringing down regional disparities gap by establishing industries in tribal and backward areas. As export of manufactured goods expand trade and commerce and brings in much needed foreign exchange, because when we are talking about manufacturing, That means value addition. Like if we are talking about yarn, yarn is sold rupees 85 per kg. If it is sold as a trouser, that means conversion from raw material to finished goods, the cost of that trouser will be rupees 800 per kg. It means value is added at every stage from fiber to yarn to fabric and to garment. And due to this, more employment, more trading, and brings in much needed foreign exchange. The countries that transform, as we all are aware about China. The countries that transform their raw materials into a wide variety of furnished goods of higher value are prosperous. Last year also we have discussed China has reduced poverty to a great extent. And the main reason is manufacturing sector. So India's prosperity lies in increasing and diversifying its manufacturing industries as quickly as possible. As we know that if more people are engaged in secondary and tertiary, that is a sign of a developed economy. And earlier also we have discussed that all the sectors of economy are interrelated. Same, agriculture and industry are not exclusive of each other. They move hand in hand. Like some industries are based on agriculture, because they are taking raw materials from primary sector, or we can call it agro-based industries. The agro-based industries in India have given a major boost to agriculture by raising its productivity. They depend on the latter for raw materials and sell their products like irrigation pumps, fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides, plastic and PVC pipes, machines and tools, etc. to the farmers. So that means development and competitiveness of manufacturing industry has not assisted agriculturists in increasing production, but also made the production process very efficient. And that's why India is also able to complete its green revolution, which we have discussed in the chapter agriculture. And as we are living in the globalized world, our industry needs to be more efficient and competitive. Self-sufficiency alone is not enough. Our manufactured goods must be at par in quality, because we have to compete in the international market. And for this, we require good quality of products, then we will be able to compete in the international market. So industrial development is the development of economy. And that's why we will discuss about contribution of industry to national economy also. After independence, our government adopted the policy, but it was basically based on primary sector, agriculture. But secondary sector was suffered, and due to this the share of manufacturing sector has stagnated at 17% of GDP. After that, last two decades, after new economic policy 1990s, the share of manufacturing sector increased. Now total of 27%, but this is much lower in comparison to some East Asian economies. The trend of growth rate in manufacturing sector for last decade around 7% per annum, but we want to increase growth rate around 12%. Since 2003, manufacturing is once again growing at the rate 9 to 10% per annum, and for to improve this productivity, economists predict that manufacturing can achieve its target over next decade. And to achieve this target, the National Manufacturing Competitiveness Council has been set up with this objective. So now the priority of the government nowadays, as we can assume, well, we have started boycotting Chinese goods, not only in India, but around the globe. So India is having the opportunities to enter in manufacturing sector. So that means we are having a bright future for this, and